Adorama TV presents Getting the Shot with Corey Rich.
Hi, I'm Corey Rich, and you're watching Adorama TV. Adorama is the place where I buy all of my still photography and video equipment, both for leisure needs and also professional needs. Today, we're going to talk about shooting a split-level fishing photograph. We're at a beautiful lake in the Sierra Nevada Mountains, just outside of my home in Lake Tahoe, and I'm working with Amy McCormick, who's a fish whisperer, as she claims, at least. I'm using an Aquatech D4 housing. It's the new Delfin D4 housing. And what I like about this housing actually is that it allows me to decide which lens I'm using and change out the ports. So I'm actually shooting on the Nikon D4S. This was designed for the D4, but the beauty of the D4S is all of the buttons are the same. I'm shooting with the 16-35mm zoom lens. It's the F4 Nikkor lens. And the beauty of putting the 16-35 in is that with the zoom control of this housing, I can actually decide whether I'm at 35, 16, or anywhere in between. In general, when I'm shooting in the water, I want to be fairly wide. The reason is the water magnifies, so 25% magnification when the camera is underwater, so 16mm quickly becomes a fairly long lens. The goal in this situation is really simple. I want to show that Amy is actually in the water. When shooting with a dome port, you want to make sure that the water is actually shedding evenly off of the lens. One of the tricks that I've learned over time is that if you spit on the lens, much like a scuba mask, rub it in, and I know that sounds kind of gross, but it actually works. Then you put the camera in the water, and when the water starts to shed, it sheds more evenly. Because of course, if you have water debris on the lens, you get an out of focus photograph. Every time I use the water housing, I pull it out of the Pelican case and I first clean all of the seals. I make sure that there's no hair or dust on any of the O-rings. And then I use a lubricant that I buy from Aquatech actually, and I lube the O-rings. And what that does is allow for a perfect seal so that no water is coming into the camera. When we approached this lake, I thought the obvious picture would be to put the camera very close to the vegetation on the left side of the bank, put something in the foreground in the frame. I made for a pretty nice photograph. I kind of allowed the reeds to frame Amy as she's casting. I found that as the clouds built and I moved a little deeper into the lake, at 16mm, I could actually really leverage the clouds in the background, that lower horizon line, which is the trees in the background, and really focus on making a more dynamic image of Amy. Shooting with the water housing takes a lot of repetition. There's a lot of variables. In this case, I chose to literally go knee deep or just slightly deeper and put the water housing in. I know I'm shooting so wide that I'm actually not even looking at the camera. I'm kind of orienting the camera, asking Amy to start casting. And then as I'm shooting the picture, I pull the water housing out and I review the images. The beauty of this housing is I can actually review the images, toggle forward and backward, and actually zoom in and check focus. As soon as I see something that I like, then I ask Amy to just repeat that action. And I just continue to shoot so that hopefully in that series of images, there's one frame that really it all comes together. This is my favorite photograph from the shoot. It really epitomizes what a split-level photograph is all about. We can see into the water, albeit it's pretty murky water. But in the background, you actually see our subject, Amy. She's doing a nice cast. We're seeing reflection of Amy in the water in the foreground, beautiful puffy clouds in the sky, and a nice clean horizon line, which is the pine trees behind Amy. And that's the best feeling in the world, when I can share the images with the person I'm photographing and they're delighted and happy to see what we've accomplished. Be sure to check out Adorama's next contest. There's all kinds of cool stuff that you can win. I'm Corey Rich and you're watching Adorama TV. There's tons of content just like this published on a regular basis for free, which is the coolest part. So be sure to follow us on our YouTube channel, check us out on social media, and we'll see you soon.
Great looking prints at low cost? Be sure to visit our easy to use online printing service. Adorama Pix has professionals who treat your images with the utmost care that you can count on. For a quick turnaround on photos, cards, or albums, use adoramapix.com.